Good morning, Tammy C. Walker here, owner of Dreams Are Reality. Today, I want to talk about what is holding you back in life. I created this channel, Dreams Are Reality, because I really feel like dreams are reality and things you desire, things you want, things you deserve can come true and come to you. I believe it. I'm a living witness and I want to help others. So back to you now. What is holding you back in your life? Only you know the answer to this question. You can talk to therapists, psychologists, psychiatrists, ministers, mentors, life coaches, teachers, professors. But at the end of the day, the answer is deep within you. For many of us, it is fear. We get comfortable, complacent, and we keep doing the same thing, but we want a new result. Sometimes people look at rich people and get mad at them, but do you know their story? Do you know how they stayed up all night to create that masterpiece song or that artwork, or how they sold CDs out of their car? Or how they were interns and worked their way up. You never know somebody's story. So it's not good to compare or be jealous, but what about your story? Create your own. Many of us, or I shouldn't say many, some of us, we ignore things. I've been told by people that I try to help, oh, my credit is bad. So I'll ask, why is your credit bad? I have things on my report that I have not paid. Well, that's where we have to be responsible with our credit. Don't be scared to look at that report. When you pull your report, you may be shocked that it's not as bad as you think. Let's just throw a scenario out there. Let's say you have 3 to 5 accounts on your credit that are not in good standing. Is one of them 6 years and 6 months old? Well, within 6 months, that's going to fall off. Do you want to pay that? Only you know the answer to that. What about the second one? Maybe it's a dental bill with a collection agency. It's $400. Can you call that collection agency and pay $200 and settle? And just look at each one and work on a plan to pay things off. You'll be shocked at how quick your credit score rises up. Once you get that done, get a credit card. It can be a small amount and start rebuilding. Make sure you pay that credit card each month. Do not be late. And do that for 12 months and you'll see an increase in your credit score. What about the housing market? It's still a good time to buy. Inventory was kind of low this spring, but still, it's a lot of programs out for first-time home buyers. Do you want a home versus renting? Do you want property versus renting? Look into it. Maybe you can't get it for 2022, but wouldn't you rather have a plan for 2023? It's always good to know where you're going, even if it's 12 months away. It makes you feel good to work on a goal. Don't give up on your dream. It could be closer than you think. And I think people are holding back in life because they don't think these things are going to happen for them. No one's going to pay me over $50,000. I can't have my own home. My credit's messed up. Love don't exist no more. I'm over 40. I can't find nobody. Men these days, they don't want nothing. These ladies, blah, blah, blah. All these things we say and hear, it's just negative talk. What you focus on grows. What you talk about grows. What you believe you deserve, you get. All of these things are so true. And as far as getting a new job, do you hear how people are complaining, saying they cannot find good employees? That means it's an employees market. Go get your job. And when you ask for that job, do a range. I would like 50 through 65,000. The last time I got hired before this job, I gave them a range. I think I said like 44 through 49. I'm not even sure. But I got whatever. The highest amount is what I got. And try that. Give a range. Make it a $15,000 range. 50 through 65, 40 through 55. And use the ATS system. It's a website called jobscan.co, jobscan.co. Put your resume on one side, put the job that you're applying for on the other. This system will tell you what keywords to put in your resume so it'll get pulled. Back in the 90s and 80s when I used to look for jobs, it was old school. You know, mail in your resume, email your resume. Now it's ATS, Applicant Tracking System. Things are computerized, so we have to keep up with the times. Always do a great cover letter. Use energy in that letter. Brag on yourself and start it off with, look no further, I am your candidate. Or this job is perfect for me and I want to show you how it's perfect for me. Make them a believer. You got to come with the energy. Be professional. Show up for your interview. Now you can show up online, but make sure you look professional, even if you're at home. And I've noticed with this modern age, with Zoom and all this other stuff, even the employers, they're becoming too lax, not getting on the camera, not being professional, not being on time. All of this stuff is still important. Just because we're more virtual doesn't mean get sloppy. Keep it classy, keep it professional, ask for what you want, clean up your credit, go get your house, ask for the salary you deserve. What is holding you back in life? Only you know. I think it's fear for some. I think it's how you grew up. Maybe in the household, money was talked about like it was limited or lacking, and maybe it was, but that doesn't have to be your story now. What is your view on money? Do you think you deserve money? I'll give you all some money tips that I do. Oh, a late beautiful lady that I used to talk to, a friend of a friend, and I would get on the phone with her and she was just phenomenal. She gave me prayers and Bible verses and she told me, get some foil, put some cinnamon in the foil and put it in your wallet. Hey, I did it and it seemed like ever since then money just comes to me. And say that, money comes to me freely. Money comes to me with ease. Say it and look in your mailbox. Expect a check. Expect good things to come to you. What is holding you back? Is it you? If it's you, think about what you want your life to look like and start journaling and working on things. You deserve it. You desire it. It is yours. It is yours. I'm going to get on out of here. You have a most beautiful day and an even better weekend. And reach for the stars. Bye-bye.